Hi guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive, sat with Tom Quayle.
How you doing?
We're talking about the new strings from our friends at Martin. Now, before you all zone out and go, oh God, strings. Don't like stick with us for a time, for the time being at least, because strings for acoustic guitars are super important.
They really, really are, yeah, absolutely.
Compared to electric guitar, I am a big believer in getting the right strings for your electric guitar, but it's more about the feel and the gauge. For acoustic guitars, it's about the only way that you can customize the sound.
Very true.
Of your existing guitar. So getting the right strings for your play style, for your guitar's sound, super important.
Yes.
Now, Martin have been making their own strings for a while. We talked about this off camera, right?
Yes, I didn't know that actually.
Yeah, yeah. So if you've been playing Martin strings, they've been made by Martin.
Right.
And they only make strings for themselves. They don't make strings for anybody else. So you can't get Martin made strings anywhere else. You can't buy them off the
interesting,
peg
right.
Under another brand, which is quite common. You know, there are a lot of ghost winders.
For sure.
You know, so which is, it's a done practice, but some companies like Martin, they wind their own. And the reason for this is because they're so kind of like into the idea of the right strings for the right guitar, that they kind of wanted to make it themselves, you know, to make sure it's absolutely bang on. They couldn't find a string that they liked.
Makes sense.
Yeah, makes a lot of sense. So, new for this year, or the new Martin SP acoustic range, which stands for superior performance, mm-hmm. It would do. And there's three types of SP strings. Now, you'd be forgiven for thinking that these different colors, green, red, blue, represent different gauges, but they don't. They're actually different kinds of strings. Now, we're gonna start with the blue. These are the pretty standard SPs, nothing standard about them. They're a very special alloy, which is basically a hybrid between their best-selling strings in the UK mm-hmm. and the best-selling strings in the US, which are the old blue dots and the purple dots.
Wow, interesting.
So they've kind of taken the best things about both and made a new alloy. Now, all three of these string gauges are essentially the same strings, but with different features. So
right.
This is the most standard of the bunch. It's kind of the vanilla one. And it's available in Phosphor Bronze or 8020 Bronze.
Right.
Now, there is a difference between the two. Mm-hmm. If you're either one guy or another.
I'm a phosphor bronze guy.
Yeah, because it's bigger and there's more high end, there's more low end.
And it's also what I'm used to as well.
Yeah, totally. Do you know, whereas the 8020 is a little bit warmer, perhaps.
Right.
Okay. There's also a bit of a difference in lifespan between the two.
Oh.
I don't know if you knew about that, but it's kind
I didn't know. No. Acoustic strings are not my forte at all. Obviously, I'm not primarily an acoustic player, so this is all good, interesting knowledge for me.
Totally, yeah. But it's, I mean, even if you're just playing the same gauge and the same brand of strings, let's say you put Martin strings on, you know, on your guitar on the regular, if you switch from Phosphor Bronze to 8020, you're going to get a different kind of sound. You're
right.
Going to get a different longevity. Phosphor Bronze generally lasts a little bit longer my experience, but it's very guitar dependent. It's very play style dependent too. So if you have a really bright guitar, you stick some Phosphor Bronze strings on it, it's going to tame it down a little bit. If you have quite a mid-focused mahogany guitar, you might think about throwing some, you know, some Phosphor Bronze on. That's going to brighten things up, make it kind of a bit bigger and richer, all that sort of stuff. The other two string sets that are available, we've got these guys, which are the silked strings.
Ooh.
Now, this is not the same as silk wrapped strings.
Yep.
All it is a little bit of silk wrapping around the ball end. So it's just the bit that goes in the bridge.
Mm.
Now, the reasoning for this is twofold, and it's primarily for people who have vintage instruments.
Right.
So if you've got a really nice old acoustic guitar, and maybe the bridge pins, they're fantastic sounding old bridge pins, but they're a bit loose because they've maybe shrunk over time or they've worn, the silk is going to help lock the bridge pin in place.
Huh.
And it's also going to protect your bridge. So it's not going to kind of cut into the bridge the way that...
Yeah, so it slightly lubricates where the string goes in.
Yeah. It's actually a little wrap of silk.
Yes.
So it looks quite nice too. Wow. But it's going to protect your vintage instrument, but it's the same string with the same tone.
Right.
Regardless of that, which is kind of cool. Now, the last one we're looking at is the lifespans. Now, these are not coated strings, but they are similar to. So they're what Martin called treated strings. It's treated for long life.
Right.
It's exactly the same string, but they're treated with a chemical compound that I don't know the makeup of, but you know, it's a special chemical compound that
adamantium.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
It's made of adamantium.
Unobtainium. So you take the existing strings and you essentially treat them with this chemical compound and then bake them.
Right.
Which basically has the effect of making them last longer. They don't last quite as long as a coated string, but they also don't have any of that coated string sound. So with the best will in the world, if you put a coating on a string, it is going to affect the tone and the feel slightly.
Yeah, without a doubt.
Yeah, really not a fan of coated strings. Don't like them at all. But that's more to do with my own skin chemistry than anything. I have very dry hands.
Yes.
So I tend to fall off coated strings. I know people who can only play coated strings.
Yeah, a good friend of mine, very acidic, kind of very sort of, very sweaty, which makes him sound terrible.
Yeah.
But yeah, very acidic kind of pH when he's playing, and he goes through uncoated strings like crazy. So they are very useful.
Yeah.
My experience with them was that they would flake, especially on acoustics, and you would end up with the flake all over the guitar.
Yeah.
And the feel of them, they have more tension and they didn't sound as good as uncoated strings either.
Yeah, they don't. They will be slightly darker.
Absolutely.
And slightly more muffled because there is a coat of Teflon on the wraps. That's not what's going on here. So this is kind of a middle ground between coated and uncoated strings, I suppose.
Yeah.
Now, an interesting thing for me is this is the Phosphor Bronze set we're holding, but we talked about the fact that 8020 goes off a little bit quicker than Phosphor Bronze. Mm-hmm. If you got the 8020 bronze in the lifespan, you could expect to retain all that same feel and tone, but it wouldn't go off quite as quick.
Okay.
Yeah. And these are the strings, by the way, I should point out, these red ones, the treated ones, are the ones that are on 95% of new Martin guitars.
Really? Okay.
The 13s on the dreadnoughts, 12s on everything else.
Which makes perfect sense because they're not going to get changed when they're sat in a store or,
exactly,
you know, in a box, in a case, you know, so it makes perfect sense they would do that. And if they're, that's interesting as well, if they're confident enough in the sales potential of that string when you lift the guitar off the peg to try it.
Yeah.
You know, if they're putting that on all those guitars, that's quite a endorsement for that particular string.
Absolutely. Yeah, I mean, and these go on everything from an £800 guitar to a £10,000
guitar. Yes, exactly. Yeah,
you know, so, really
very
great strings. I've played them. I'm a big fan. Though, obviously, when we've reviewed Martin guitars in the past, that's what they've been strung with. They feel good. They sound good. The first thing that, again, that struck me when we got that lovely, if you watched our video with the modern deluxe Martin that we played, the first thing that struck me, I got it out of the case and I was like, oh, thank heavens, it hasn't got coated strings. You know, I thought it was double. Yeah, this is great. That turns out it has treated strings, which is good for me. So no slur on coated strings. If that's your jam, then
totally. They work for people, you know, certain people. They work really well.
Totally. Absolutely. Now, the other 5% of Martin guitars are strung up with these guys.
Oh, wow.
Which are the Martin Retros. Now, these are an entirely different kind of string. They're very very warm and very transparent sounding without a whole lot of transient on the string. And they kind of evoke that old kind of, like old early blues kind of sound.
Yeah, my dad has a 1918 Martin at home.
Ah, now.
So.
Yeah, that might be, actually, what he needs is he needs these guys protect his vintage instruments.
Yes.
But even still, this is going to give you that really great kind of, absolutely. You know, but this is the one that's on, the strings that are on the junior dreadnoughts. So if you remember the video we did,
dreadnoughts
had those. They look a bit like electric strings and they feel a bit like electric strings, but they're not. They're specially designed kind of acoustic strings.
Interesting.
That are, but they have a real different kind of sound. So if you're looking for that kind of old school, kind of like very mid-range focused, like Robert Johnson kind of vibe.
Yeah, right.
That's it. Now, I should point out that Martin, as standard, only put these on mahogany guitars.
Right.
Because mahogany has that, again, that very focused, punchy mid-range. That's where these come in.
Okay.
So they're the new acoustic strings.
Right.
However, there's also all of these colorful guys. This is Martin's Darko range of strings.
Now,
you might have seen these. You might not have known they were Martin strings.
I've never seen these before in my life.
These are very affordable electric strings.
Right.
Or the idea. But they're still made by Martin in the same place. They're just not, they don't have the same premium appointments as something like this, for example. I'll get the right way up there.
Yeah.
But yeah, basically what they are is they're your standard nickel round acoustic strings that are comparable to D'Addario XLs or to Ernie Ball Slinkies. It's that kind of string. One thing, if this makes a difference to you, is that they are on the right side of a fiver in the UK.
Wow.
So they're about £4.50 at the time of recording, I think.
So especially if you're someone like me where acoustic is a small part of what you do.
Well, these are electric strings. So,
these are electric strings.
So
that's incredible.
It's all right, isn't
it? Less than a fiver.
Wow. I remember that was the price of strings when I was a kid. So
absolutely.
There's nothing fancy about them. They're just strings, you know, but they're perfectly good strings. It says compared to leading brands.
Yeah, yeah.
They're every bit as good, I think. Personally, I mean, I will say that different strings by different manufacturers do have a different feel,
yes,
a different tone.
Without a doubt.
If you compare a set of 10s to a set of 10s by a different manufacturer, there is going to be a difference. How noticeable that difference is depends how nerdy you are. If you're the kind of character that just wants a set of strings, then perfect, ideal. I've had these on my guitar, been perfectly happy with them.
You know, and there's all the standard gauges here. So you've I've got 8 to 38, 9 to 42, 10 to 46, and then a heavier bottom with 10 to 40, 52, 11 to 48, and then there's the heaviest set, the 12 to 56.
Yeah. So they cover everything.
No, absolutely not. That's amazing to get strings for that cost these days.
Pretty serious.
They have become quite an expensive item in recent years.
Yeah, you know, man.
With good reason, by the way.
Yeah, of course, you know.
There's lots of innovation going in, and you may agree or disagree with how interesting the innovation is. I'm very into some of the innovation, especially when it comes to these new strings which are not coated anymore. I think there's a little bit of a backlash, but people, the coated thing was great initially, and some people, as we mentioned before, really, really like them, and that's fantastic.
Yeah.
But the companies now are trying to move away from the coated thing in some ways and develop a string that's got longevity without the coating on. Mm. So there's a lot of innovation going on.
Absolutely.
But also at the other end of the market, to have affordable but good quality strings is very important as well.
Totally. Now, this is huge for, especially for younger guitar players, you know, for my students.
Yeah.
I often have this argument with them. It's not an argument because it's very one-sided.
You will.
I'm always, you know, asking them, why haven't you changed your strings?
Yes.
Your guitar sounds disgusting. Your intonation's awful.
Looks disgusting.
It looks disgusting. I don't want to play it.
Yes.
Why haven't you changed your strings? And the argument normally comes back. I normally teach at university age, so the argument normally comes back, oh, strings are too expensive, which is very, very much not true. Especially if you ask them how much they spent on the weekend. Do you know, how much did you spend in the pub? But, you know, fair play. You know, if you're working on a budget, strings can be an expense. That is a way of keeping costs down.
Nice work,
to
Martin.
My mind.
I like it.
And they're great. You know, there's absolutely nothing wrong with them. If you want something a bit more high end, maybe that's not the direction you go in.
And they're making those as well.
They're making those too.
They're winding those themselves.
So that's, again, you won't find those made for anybody else.
Right.
They're made in Martin's factory by Martin on Martin's proprietary machines that they built themselves, designed themselves, and it's the same machines that these guys are wound on, which is very cool. So these ones, by contrast, are very much more high-end, high-performance strings with a very, very clever alloy that's going to make your lovely acoustic guitar, whether it's an affordable Martin or whether it's an expensive one or whether it's any other brand, it's going to make it sound its absolute best. But if you only want a cheap set of strings, there are darker acoustic strings available as well.
Right.
So, although having said that,
well,
really got to give these a try. I mean,
even though you say there's affordable Martins, they're all a moderate to big investment, and so you might as well have it sounding as good as you possibly can do.
Totally.
And you're less likely to snap acoustic strings as well.
Yeah, that's, you know, true.
So you're not going to go through strings quite as often.
Yeah.
So it's worth the investment, I think.
Even if you do, you can consider something like the lifespans. Now, there's an economy in this with long-lasting strings. You know, let's pull some figures out of nowhere. Let's say, for argument's sake, that you would pay. That's not to say that this is the price of these strings. You know, we're not going to comment on that, but let's say, for argument's sake, that you were buying £5 set of strings and you change them every 2-3 weeks, for argument's sake. Let's say you bought a £15 set of strings that were going to last you for ages and that lasts you 3 months. You've saved a lot of money in the long run.
Yes, absolutely.
I think. And your guitar sounds better, plays better, stays in tune longer. The other thing with this one is that changing your strings is actually good for your guitar's health and longevity, and it actually makes your guitar sound better over the long term, not just in the immediate term, because if you have new strings on you're going to be transferring more energy into your guitar's top.
Very interesting, yeah.
Which is actually going to cause it to open up and sound better over time. And that's why old guitars that have been played a lot sound better. Not to mention the fact that it's kinder on your frets. You're not going to gunk up your fingerboard and need to clean it as often. And we all know, if we've seen guitars that have been left neglected, sometimes you can never get that fingerboard quite as clean as you'd like it.
Yep.
So just change strings. Don't know what you're doing watching this video, change your strings. Maybe with some of these, because they're great. But
super sales pitch, amazing.
No. All joking aside, it is good for your guitar.
It's a good point.
To have fresh strings on. And it's good for your fingers, it's a better playing experience. We've all seen guys who've got really expensive guitars with gunky strings, and you just pull your hair out going, why have you done this?
Yeah.
So in a nutshell, anyway, listen, that's the new Martin range of strings. I've played them, we've both played them. They sound great. You know, how much of that we can attribute to the wonderful guitar they were on, who knows, but they feel good, sound good. There's definitely something for everybody as well. If you're after a long-lasting string, we've got the lifespans. These guys will do you just fine if you're not too worried about the longevity and you're maybe changing strings more often. If you've got a vintage instrument, this is going to protect it and help those strings stay in place. And if you want that old school woody blues tone, these are the retros too. All available in a bunch of different gauges in a plethora, well, two different materials, but that's basically a plethora. And there's really affordable Darko strings if you want them to.
Very cool. Very cool. So we haven't played in this video, by the way, guys. We don't have any Martins here, so we couldn't play for you. But nope. I think that gives you a good overview of those strings.
But there is more Martin content coming. We've got some lovely guitars to show you in the future. You can, of course, go and check out our individual reviews of the new Martin Modern Deluxe series that I've done. Tom's done the Junior Dreadnought.
And check out our jam.
Absolutely. Yeah, it's so much fun. We're going to do another one of those again for you soon. So make sure, if you're watching this on the GI YouTube channel, make sure you subscribe and all that good business so you can see more Martin stuff from us when it comes. We'll leave it there. My name's Nick Jennison.
Tom Quayle.
See you next time.
Bye-bye.